Hi everyone, I'm Vishnu Subramaniam, founder of JarvisLabs. In this video, we are going to figure out how to use images as prompts to a stable diffusion model rather than the typical text as prompts for stable diffusion model, right? Along with that, we'll also see how to apply style transfer so that you can have an image of a particular style that we give as input. And third thing is we also do the famous face wrap. We use a technique called IP adapter and we use the latest version of that, and we do all of these things in ComfyUI as usual, right? So to start with, I've created a bunch of workflows. The basic workflow gives this idea of how to pass this image as an input to the stable diffusion model and generate an image, right? So let's say we want more images similar to this shoes. So this workflow does that. Okay, so this weight has to be 1. When it is 1, it gives you just similar images, right? When we want to change something in the image, then what we can do is we can add some text. We can also pass text as an input to the workflow. Let's say I want a yellow shoe, right? So we should probably get a yellow shoe, right? So there's some part of it which is pink. That's basically coming from this weight. A node here responsible for converting this image and combining the model weights is IP adapter. It has a couple of important parameters. One is weight. So here we can say apply it probably 50-50. So basically we are saying apply 50% of the image weights and 50% of the text weights, right? Now we should have at the end of the day, it's a probabilistic model. So we should have a shoe which is probably fully yellow in color. Yes, the logo is still pink, but it has got similar texture and it's also following the color which we gave, right? So this is a very simple example of how you can use images to generate similar images. So basically the idea is, in case you come across an image probably in a different platform which you want to use, or you want to create similar images, instead of trying to figure out the best prompt, you can just bring in the image and use IP adapter to generate more similar images. And you can also use the text to control the output of the generated images. So what we're going to do is, next one is do a style transfer. Let's say now we don't want just an image, but we want images to be generated in a particular style, right? In this case, so let's do the unbypass. Okay, select group nodes to always, right? So once you do that, this is active. So what we will also do is we will bypass this group so that just run this, right? So here what I want to do is we want to use image which is of glass painting kind of thing, and want to generate images which are of that particular style, right? So the only difference between the previous workflow and this workflow is the weight type. We are using something called style transfer, right? So it changes the way it combines the weights from the image and the model, which allows us to have beautifully generated images in a particular style, right? So before we go to the next one, let's see what is happening in these two nodes. So if you have observed closely, what we can see is these few nodes are from the default workflow that you would find in ComfyUI, which I have explained in one of my previous workflow. We have built that from scratch, right? The only three nodes that are new to this workflow, the IP adapter basic workflow, is there is something called unified loader, and there is something called IP adapter, and this one is a typical load image, right? So what IP adapter unified loader is doing is it's bringing in a model. And what IP adapter node is doing is it's combining the model's out weights. It's combining these weights from this loader with the model that we are choosing, right? In this case, I've chosen a Turbo Vision XL model. Meters we have chosen here, like weight, weight type. It combines the weights of the IP adapter model and the model that we've chosen, in this case, Turbo Vision XL, right? And it converts this image using something called Clip Vision, which is part of your SDXL model, and converts this into prompts, right? And that's how we are able to generate these beautiful images. There are other similar techniques for converting images into prompts, but IP adapter is so far the best technique for generating images which which are similar to the input image that you have given, and also it works really well for face swapping, right? So which is a technique that you have to be careful when you use it. I hope no one uses it for anything bad, right? So let's take a photo of a person. This is just for demonstrative purpose. So please use it responsibly and set the group to active. So what we are doing here is we're going to see two techniques to do the same. The first one is a very simple one, which is like a slight improvement to our earlier workflow. But the second one is going to be very specific for the faces, which would give us slightly better results or a more perfect result. So what we are doing is we have changed it to a photo, and the weight type from style transfer, we have changed it to standard, except this, except there's a small changes in the positive prompt and negative prompt. Everything else remains same. Let's say a Q prompt. Hopefully we get an image that is similar to this actress, right? So as we can see here, it's not really that great. It's not doing a very good job. So what we will do is, instead of using the IP adapter unified loader, which is the common one, which can work on multiple things, the IP adapter V2 has a specific loader and the IP adapter apply node, which works way better for faces. So we will try to use that. So let's try to bypass this group. Let's go to this new workflow and let's activate it. Okay. So now let's run it. We are running this workflow. It's getting run, view queue, right? So let's see what is the quality of the image that it's being generated. It can take few seconds because it's doing multiple things. Okay, hopefully the image is better, but I think it can be still better. So what I'll do is I'll generate one more image. Usually this technique gives way better results, as we can see that the image quality is good, and it's also combining different styling that's coming from the LoRAs here. So what we can also play is we can say, we can change these values to get different results. And there are two weights here. One is for the face ID V2, that's the loader we are using. We'll just explain that in a minute. We can play around with these parameters. So what we have also observed is, for different input images, you may have to play with these steps, sometimes increasing the steps and increasing or decreasing the CFG. That's something which you have to do. So now we have got an image which is pretty closer to the input image that we have given, right? And I've just used a very simple prompt, right? So let's see what is happening here and here and compare it with the previous workflow, right? Previous workflow, we use something called Unified Loader. Here we are using something called Unified Loader Face ID, right? Which is specifically built for face. And the adapter is also specific for face ID. So it can, the library can do a lot of customizations which are very specific to face, right? So we will also be attaching this workflow in the YouTube description, so you can download it and you can try it on your laptop. If you're trying it on your laptop, please make sure that you install the IP adapter nodes, which you can go to this manager and probably use install custom nodes. I think here we have already installed. So let's say filter all the ones which is installed, right? And so this one is what this ComfyUI adapter plus, this is the node that we are using. If you are using a JarvisLabs instance, this custom node is already pre-installed for you, and you have to add all the right models in the right locations before you get started. By the way, if you're using a JarvisLabs instance, it comes pre-installed for you so that you don't have to worry about it. So in the next video, we will explore how you can use IP adapter V2 for doing a lot of different things, like how do we combine that with ControlNet and a lot more. Probably sometime we'll see how we can use IP adapter, ControlNet, and something like AnimateDiff to create beautiful animations. So if you have any comments or if you face any challenges, please leave it in the comments. We will try our best to answer it. Or you can also join our Discord group where we are very active. We are trying to build this Discord group for JarvisLabs and more. Hope you like this video. If you like it, please hit the like button and subscribe. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.